celebrate Shavuot as we receive the Torah, we have been blessed that we as a community have been able to give a Torah to the Jews of Azerbaijan just a couple of years ago. So this evening, I'm going to call upon cantor Lisa Picot, who will sing not one, not two, but three anthems for us.
Officials, diplomats, and other world leaders through our 22 United States regional offices, 11 global posts, and 35 international partnerships. Through these relationships and our international presence, AJC impacts opinion leaders,
which I consider so dear to my heart. We've established this wonderful relationship with your community since 3 years, when we were standing here on this very stage, when the Sinai Temple was donating a beautiful Sefer Torah to our mountainous Jewish community. And the president of the community is here, together with us, Mr. Bilal Yebdayev. Thank you, thank you. And this was, believe me, very incredible legends which are in Azerbaijan. I have been led by Mubariz Gurbanli, member of our cabinet, and chairman of the State Committee on Religious Affairs. And I spent some time today with the delegation, and it has filled my heart with warmth when I saw these people interacting with each other so friendly, so nicely, as if there was just one religion in the world, and that's the religion of humanity. Without further ado, I would like to introduce you a short film that was prepared by the State Committee on the work with the religious associations.
Allah ve celallah. Ben Sinai Mabedine, onun rehberliğine, bizim için bize güzel şerait yaratığına göre teşekkür ederim ve hamınızı salamlıyorum.
Ravi Sherman, dear gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, we are in the Sinai Temple today. I would like to express my gratitude to all of you. Thank you for coming and thank you for having us here.
Bizim Los Angeles'taki konsolosluğumuzun bu cümlede insanlar olan dini konferansların rehberleri iştirak edir. Yahudi icmasının rəhbəri bayaq təqdim olunur. Bilik müəllim, sonra Avropa yadlərinin rəhbəri Aleksandr Şarovski, digər bizim burada olan Qafqaz müsəlmanları qarəsi Şeyh İslamın muavini, həmçinin Alban Budiyev kilsəsinin rəhbəri iştirak edir və bu iştirakın birlikdə olması Azərbaycanın müxtəlif dinləri olan münasibətinin göstərisidir. Rəsmən Azərbaycanda bunun 31-i qeyri-müsəlman dini icmasıdır. Bunun
18'i, 17'si Hristiyan din icmasıdır. 8 Yahudi icması Azerbaycan'da qeydiyyatdan keçib. Bundan başqa Azerbaycan'da Bəhailər də var, Zərdüşlər var, Krishna Şuru icması var və digər kiçik icmalar var.
According to the law in Azerbaijan, religious committees
var. Halbuki Sovetlər dağılanda cəmi 17 məscid var idi. Hazırda 8 sinagog fəaliyyət göstərir. Bir sinagog tikilməkdədir. Eyni zamanda Azərbaycanda 14 Hristiyan kilsəsi var. Bunun içərisində Lutheran, Protestant, o cümlədən Katolik kilsələri var.
Poliyetnik, polikonfesyal ölkədir və bu gün də belədir.
Azerbaijan is historically multi-ethnic and multi-confessional state.
Mən Azərbaycan gözəl bir yerdə yerləşirəm və orada olan bizim icma ilə Müslüman icma və Yahudi icma bir məkəndə yaşayır.
Прежде всего я хочу всех вас поприветствовать, дорогие дамы и господа.
I would like to greet all of you.
Поздравить с 70-летием государственности Израиля.
And I would like to congratulate you on the statehood this 70-year anniversary of Israel.
И с наступающим праздником, когда который вы вспоминаете, как вам была дана Тора.
I would congratulate you on the upcoming holiday, Shavuot.
Что мы делаем для того, чтобы молодое поколение росло в духе толерантности и межрелигиозного диалога? Был такой вопрос. Я отвечу, что мы делаем ничего, мы не учим молодое поколение толерантности и межрелигиозному диалогу. Они сами учатся на Урбан Байрам или Рамазан Байрам.
If they see that Christian and Jewish community congratulate Muslim community on Ramadan or on Eid al-Adha, his so-called sacrificing day.
Если они видят, что их родители, вне зависимости от национальной и религиозной принадлежности, делят друг с другом и горе, и радость.
If they see that regardless their religion, all people share their good moments and bad moments.
Родные нам люди.
Not because of Mike, but because there are people sitting here are very close to my heart.
Поверьте мне, я приехал с братьями. Это не пропаганда, это радость от того, что мы вас увидели и вы нас понимаете. Мы любим вас. Спасибо вам. Спасибо вам.
And we came here with our brothers, and this is not...
Live side by side, peacefully, with their Muslim and Christian counterparts. We at AJC not only have a wonderful partnership with the Consulate General of Azerbaijan, but we also see Consul General Nassim Agayev, his family. Nassimi, we are so grateful for all that you do for your country, and so for the past 11 years consecutively. I personally had the pleasure of visiting Azerbaijan on an AJC mission in 2015, where I met, along with others from our delegation, with we are honored and excited have this opportunity to welcome Azerbaijan's interfaith community to Los Angeles. Thank you.
The first century AC. According to the medieval historian of the Caucasian Albania, Moses of Kalamkatuik, Saint Eliseus, a disciple of Saint Thaddeus of Edessa, arrived in Gis, a town in the Caucasian Albania, the ancient predecessor of modern Azerbaijan. Here, as the annals of history says, he built the first church in the Caucasus, and 3 centuries later, Christianity was accepted as the state religion of the Kingdom of the Caucasian Albania. Azerbaijanis preserved this ancient church, which is in the modern-day village of Kish, in the northwestern region of Shaki. Lead east and west for thousands of years. The Silk Road helped to develop a unique Azerbaijani characteristic, a fusion of hospitality and tolerance towards people of other races and religions. Jews first settled in the hospitable land of Azerbaijan in the 5th century BC, seeking refuge from the destruction of Jerusalem by Nebuchadnezzar. Muslim Azerbaijanis and Christian Georgians come together at this unique church to celebrate the festival Kumakoba, in Christian tradition, the St. George's Day. Over the years, with Azerbaijan becoming the world's prominent petroleum production center, oil magnates, philanthropists, and government officials have contributed to the construction, preservation, and renovation of many non-Muslim shrines. An outstanding example is the Cathedral of the Holy Mirth Bearers, built in 1909 by prominent Azerbaijani Muslim oil tycoon and philanthropist Haji Zeynalabdin.